Episode 2236, Failure is So Important.
It's time to train for life and love your journey. In this episode of Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, you'll learn new ways to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew your mind, body, and spirit. Please welcome your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Kristianne Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people drive. Happy, happy day, rise and shine. It is a brand new start to a beautiful week. It's Mindset Monday. Are you ready to get your leadership moving? You are called to lead people, the world that you touch, so you can impact those around you. It's time to understand that failure is so important. For those of you who are brand new to Create You Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com, where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple strategy, everyday solutions to live, love, and impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. J.K. Rowling said this, "Failure is so important. We speak about success all the time, but it is the ability to resist or use failure that often leads to greater success." She goes on to say, "I've met people who don't want to try for fear of failing." Have you ever said no or stalled because of your fear of failing? I can think of many times where I hesitated, resisted, or even ignored the action right in front of me for fear of failing. But yet, at the same time, the resistance that ultimately caused me to jump brought the greatest reward. You know what I say, one step at a time leads to miles of greatness. It's that one step at a time. It's not always taking 10 or 12 or 13 steps all at one time. But it does require us to jump once in a while. Who would have thought failing would lead to success? But that is how we learn regardless of our age. The only difference is that the younger we are, the faster we get back up. The older we are, the slower we get back up. Yeah, I know. Because you see, 2 days ago, I fell. Big, huge belly flop on the hardwood floor in our home. Yes, and I was wearing flip-flops, and it involved a cord to the vacuum cleaner. Now, all I can say is I got a couple bruises on one knee. I feel a little flat on the front side because I really hit it hard. But you see, if I was younger, I would have jumped right back up. But there I laid, not quite a half a century old. And I'm laying there going, oh my gosh, like I really did just do that. Luckily, I did not hit my face. My arms took a lot of the blow and so did my right knee. But otherwise, I'm fine. As I laid there, though, for a moment, I was like, okay, maybe I shouldn't move. Let's just make sure everything's intact. Like, do my fingers still move? Okay, I'm breathing. Good thing. My legs, yes, one up, one laying down. Okay, they're still connected. No problem. And I really was caught between laughing at myself because it was really stupid. I was taking down the Christmas trees. Yes, we only have one left, by the way. Five of the six are down, put away. Now I just have Hallmark in my room right now for Christmas that I have to put all away and put it into storage. So that's going to be another day or so. But I got one more tree left. And so I was so excited. I had my vacuum cleaner out. And it's one of those that's built into the wall. So you have to have it plugged in. And then you have the big cord. And anyway, it's just a long process. And it was dusk inside the house. So I didn't have any lights on in this room. And my flip-flop hit it just right. It caught between my toes and the top of the flip-flop, not the bottom. And I caught that thing. And I just did a full-on belly flop on that wood floor. And oh boy, did I smack it hard. I mean, it was hard. And then I had stuff in my hands. I had food and it just went everywhere. So of course I'm laying there going, okay, I'm breathing. This is good. Nothing's broken. I can breathe. But I was mad at myself. And then it hurt too. I mean, a belly flop on the floor at my age, I'm like, this is not good. I can deal with my back being out, which by the way is doing fine now. Thank goodness. A few days down, hot pad, some exercises. Thank you for those who sent in the recommendations. I very much appreciate it. I worked on it and I'm feeling great until I do this belly flop. Well, who would have thought though that failure would lead to success? And you're like, what? How can a belly flop on a hardwood floor lead to your success, Kristianne? Well, guess what? I got back up. And I'm alive to speak about it. No broken bones. I told my husband, I said, you know what, hun? I got to say, I'm pretty strong. My bones aren't that fragile. He goes, yes, hun, you're a beast. And he meant that in a most loving way. Now, of course, I have to tell you, though, nobody came to my rescue. Everybody was home. But here I was, flat out on my belly, except for our youngest son, G-Man. He heard everything go. And he's like, Mom? And I was like, yeah, because I was caught between whether I should be laughing or crying or just flat out mad at myself. I didn't know what to do, but I was flustered because I was like, seriously, this was really stupid. Just like my back. I was like, this is stupid. Turn on a light, people. When your house is at dusk and you really can't see things, turn a light on. Well, I didn't think anything of it because I usually don't have the vacuum cleaner out with the cord across the area that I was walking where I would go sprawling out, you know, head first, basically with the belly flop. Well, he comes downstairs. He goes, Mom, are you okay? And he sees me laying there. I'm like, yeah. He goes, I thought I heard something. It sounded like the ice machine or something. I was like, nope, that was my body. And he's like, oh, okay. He goes, can you feel everything? And he was concerned. I said, yes. And so I said, all right, well, let me just sit up here slowly, make sure that my head's all attached. And so I sat down and I said, okay, I'm going to get up. Will you help me? He goes, yes. I said, all right, well, be careful. This knee hit harder than the other one. So I got up, stood to my feet slowly. Everything was fine. No big deal. You see, sometimes we have to fall flat on our face in order to understand the strength and the resilience that we have within us. Today is about failing so you can be rewarded with success. You owe it to yourself, your family, your dreams, and to God to push your excuses aside and move forward with confidence, come fail or success. That is your Kiss to Keep It Simple strategy. Push your excuses aside and move forward with confidence, come fail or success. You, my dear friend, are created for so much more than you can ever dream. There is a burning fire in your belly. You have to be ready to move when you're called to move. And I know, because I've been called many times. Different seasons, different chapters of my life. But there have been times that I've kind of hesitated. I stepped back instead of stepping forward. I was afraid. Fear of failure. Yet failure is so important. If you are going to move past the fear, past your failure, and get to that success, that achievement on the other side, you have to push and move forward and then go through the trash. Oh yeah, T-R-A-S-H. Have you ever thrown something away and then wish like, oh my gosh, I wish I would have kept it. And then you have to dig back through the trash. Well, this is kind of what we're looking at here. We're going to break it down, T-R-A-S-H. Number one, T, trash the excuses. That's where you got to start. You need to give up what is holding you back and not leading you to your dreams. Think of it as differentiating between the calm voice and the chaotic voice. The one that says, oh my gosh, if you do this, you won't believe what might happen. Oh yeah, you'll be embarrassed. Your family will talk about you. Your friends, they will never acknowledge you ever again. And you know what? Oh, if you really think about it, you're going to be stupid if you try it because you know how many other people have tried this? Yeah, that's crazy. Okay, that's the chaotic voice in your head. The calm voice. You got a dream. I've given you a vision. You have a mission to fulfill. And I know you don't understand. You may not think you have everything that you need. But I know you can do it. That's the calm voice. You've got to differentiate between that chaotic voice and the calm voice. Trash the excuses. Get rid of them. I know it's easy to hold on to them because they're always around. They're the ones that will hang out with you. When you're feeling down, oh, they show up to the pity party like, yeah, baby, I told you so. This was awesome. That's not the kind of party you want to have. You want to have that celebration that says, yeah, I've been grooming you for this. I've been preparing each and every step that you've taken. And it's led you to here today at this moment in time to create your now. So trash those excuses. Get rid of them. Number two, R, refresh your perspective. We all need a refreshment. This is the calm before the storm of greatness. This is where you see the truths for what they are so you can respond accordingly. So much of our life is filled with the lies and the stories that we make up. We pretend a lot of this stuff. We make believe the bad and we forget about all the good. So refresh your perspective, because when you do that, you can respond accordingly, which leads you to number three, aim. Action ignites motivation. You got it. One step at a time leads to miles of greatness. It's one step at a time. That one step might be writing 50 words a day. Maybe it's reading a chapter every single day. Maybe it's spending time with God more often. Maybe it's taking something off your calendar and making room for something else. Using no before you use yes. But it requires you to aim. Action ignites motivation. Number four, S, satisfy the belly. Oh, yeah. You got that hunger. Reminds me of Les Brown. He goes, you got to have that hunger. I can't do his voice, but man, you know, it's that raspiness. I love him. You got to satisfy the belly. This is the ache and the fire within you. What's your ambition and where do you want to take it? Here is where you satisfy your calling. Now, am I telling you that it's going to happen overnight? That you satisfy your belly and you're like, oh yeah, I'm going to hit that success? No. There's going to be a journey that's going to happen. It's not a destination. But in the process, you're going to satisfy that hunger. Satisfy that belly. And finally, number five, H. Honor yourself. This is where you rediscover that you are a diamond in the rough. You are absolutely precious, beautiful, incredible, passionate. You're intricately woven together with dreams and ambitions that go much farther than you can ever see or imagine. So honor yourself. No, you don't have everything you need, but I promise you this, God will give you everything at the right time. But you have to be willing to take out the trash. Are you willing to do that? Most of us don't like to worry about trash. You know, in my household, I'm the one who takes out the trash. Yes, my kids can do it. But you know what? Sometimes they make bigger messes than the trash in the trash can itself. So mama's just like, yeah, I don't want to clean up two or three messes. I would rather just take the trash. Plus, we recycle. We have two or three different bins. It's just easier. They all have different schedules. They take out little things, but I take it down to the road most of the time, unless if I'm traveling, which of course lately I have not been traveling. And so I think it's very rewarding to say, you know what? Yeah, I got to take out the trash. Because trash, it's not really comforting, is it? You don't really want to hang out with it. Well, you see, life begins at the end of your comfort zone. I can tell you all this because, you see, I myself have been fearful of failing. And I'm not talking about just 2, 3, 4 years ago, 10 years ago, 20 years ago, which, yeah, all that's true. I'm talking about recently. Have you ever listened to my episode on certain ones where I say, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy? Have you ever wondered, where is AIM? Well, it's confession day too here. I'm just going to lay it all out there. This woman here does not want to disappoint, ever. Period. End of story. Mark it with a period, exclamation point, exclamation point. I do not want to fail you. But you see, I already have. Because I haven't opened up the doors to AIM. And that's my fault. And I have to live with that. But this is my pledge to you. March of 2021, mark it down. We've got some exciting things happening in March. Now, I'm telling you this, we're a week away, aren't we? Oh, yeah. Do you think I'm comfortable right now? Oh, no. I'm about ready to have an accident as I'm recording this. It's like, can I be in the bathroom? Because, my stomach is going all over the place. But if I ask you to come out of your comfort zone and be willing to say, you know what? I'm okay if I fail because I can get back up. If I can belly flop on a hardwood floor and come back up with all my parts attached, praise the Lord. No broken bones. Praise the Lord. Just a little bit of, as I fell down and kind of like, oh my gosh, I don't believe I just did that. And frustration with myself. Then guess what? You better believe I can open up the doors to AIM. So here is my promise to you. I've never used that word here before. I've said, I'm thinking about it. You know, look at it around the corner. And then we've had things happen. Moving. Moving's a big deal. I've moved a lot in my life. And when you move with children, oh my goodness, talk about setbacks. There are a lot of setbacks you have to come back from. And then you put in there trying to become part of a new community. And then you're settling in. And then you have a pandemic. And then, right, all of these and then. You know what? There's always going to be and then. Do you ever feel that way too? Gosh darn it, I just wish there was an end to my and then. For me, my gift to you is my promise. March, mark it down. The doors of AIM are opening. And I'm so excited and I'm so nervous, but I am absolutely thrilled, not just for me, but for you. Because we get to come together as a community, we get to start coming together and supporting each other more so than us just on the podcast. And yes, I love this. Is this going to wait? No. But if you like this, you're going to have 100 times more. But you see, I too had to realize I got to take out the trash. I've got to bury those excuses. I got to refresh my perspective. What's more important? Me failing and making a few mistakes with all of you around or me not doing anything at all? I'd rather fail with you than without you. And that's what I'm doing. AIM, action ignites motivation. That's what it stands for. And here, I'm keeping the doors closed. How is that helping anybody? It doesn't. I want you to be able to go and live the life of your dreams. And I want you to be able to love whomever God places in your path so you can impact the world that you touch. And that's where AIM comes in. Living life is not just something you attend once a week. You got to show up every day. I'm telling you, it's going to be spectacular. You want to be in on it. So pay close attention. Mark your calendars. I promise it's happening. We've got lots of surprises in March. Woo! It's making me nervous. Talk about taking out the trash. Ooh, dear. Talk about a fire in the belly. God's got it burning. And it's exciting. But remember, life begins at the end of your comfort zone. Are you ready to say yes to that fire within you? Are you ready to take aim and say, you know what? I am all in, girl. I am headed there. I'm with you. And if you can do a belly flop on a hardwood floor, so can I. Let's do it together. If we can weather the storm of this crazy winter storm of the South, if we can weather the storm of the pandemic, if we can weather the storm of just our everyday stuff, our busyness, our health, our jobs, our children, our spouses. If we can go through life, wouldn't it be better to go through it together? Being able to come together. But we all have to be willing to take that one step. So today I want to challenge you. Failure is so important. It's time to be willing to take that belly flop on that hardwood floor. Go out, be present, be incredible, be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a beautiful day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.